Welcome back to the channel, RPA Champions. In today's video, we are going to be building another really cool automation. We are going to be automating the creation of carousels. Carousels that we can post on LinkedIn, on Instagram, on Facebook, or wherever we want. Carousels that look just like this one that I have created right here, but we're going to be able to create them in the dozens in a matter of seconds using AI and different tools. We're going to put together a process that is going to automate this entire process that used to be manual and probably repetitive. To do this, we are going to start with Canva. Canva is a marketing tool used to create different pieces of marketing content, from slides to different backgrounds to covers for different pieces of content, and also LinkedIn carousels. So let's pick any one of these templates would do. This template looks pretty good, so let's pick this template. And the idea is to use AI to generate the content of these slides and then use automation to create dozens and dozens of these slides, putting the content that was generated by AI inside of these slides and then having different versions of this same content. All right, so let's see how to do this. We have opened Canva, and inside of Canva, we wanna automate the creation of this. There's five slides. Each slide is made out of a similar approach, meaning there is a title and there is a description. Why is this important? Because right now we are going to create an Excel sheet that is going to be populated by AI with the content that is going to go inside of these slides right here. So we have a title and a description on each slide. Let me fill this out and I'll be right back. All right, now that we have a Excel file that looks something like this, it reflects the different content of these slides. Why? Because we are going to be putting inside of this Excel sheet everything that is going to make up one of these templates that we create. So for example, I have a main title. This is going to be generated by AI and is going to be dynamic. This reflects in the Excel that I have created as main title, title slide, and then description. And then we continue for the next slide, the next slide, the next slide, and so on. So you get the idea. You can have kind of pretty much any kind of content and you can automate it like this. Now, let's create the content that we're going to put in here. To do this, we can use Claude, we can use Gemini, we can use ChatGPT. In this example, we're going to be using ChatGPT, and I'm going to show you what I have done previously. I have put ChatGPT into context by giving it a prompt, giving it some instructions. Now you can do this any way you want. The idea here is to get some pretty good content, content that we don't have to edit ourselves, that is the right length, that is the right tone for our audience. So it might be a little bit of a conversation between you and ChatGPT or any other kind of tool that you are using, Gemini, Claude, and so forth. So once you go back and forth and you put ChatGPT in context and has all of the information to create good content, because if you just write it to fill out that Excel sheet with different pieces of content, it will produce not the best content, and it's going to be clear that is AI. So we're going to do a little bit of back and forward conversation until we get a list of things that might be interesting for us. So let's add this content right here to our slides. To make it a little bit clearer, I'm just going to reduce the slides to four slides. So I'm going to delete this final slides and just keep slide four and the title on slide four. So let's go and modify our template. So on the last slide, we're just going to leave a bigger closing title. This is what our template is going to look like. Now, once our Excel slide is ready with as many examples as we want, we can just download this as a CSV or a Excel. I'm going to download it as a CSV. And after that, we're going to go back to Canva. In Canva, we are going to look for data automation. If you go to the Canva page and you go into the app section and you search for autofill, you're going to find this data autofill. We're going to click on this, click on CSV and Excel, and import the Excel sheet that we have created. Now it's all about linking this Excel sheet. We're going to click on the title, connect the data, click on the main title, and this is going to become the main title of this slide. Now we're going to go on the first one and then click on connect, title of first slide. And we're going to continue doing this for all of the different fields that we want automatic, dynamic, and that we want imported from our Excel sheet. Once this is done, we are ready to generate our content. Once we have added all of the dynamic fields from our Excel, we can generate the five designs that we have inside of our Excel sheet. So right here, we have these six different pieces of content that we want to create. And this is what we get in the end. Right now, it looks a little bit like a mess. However, we can download it as a PDF, as images, as whatever we want. Let's download it as a sample PDF. Then we can break it down into five pages per PDF because each one of these is made out of five. But let's just take a look at what we have created in just a couple of seconds. Now we know this process. And once we set up our template, we can automatically add content to our template, import it, and generate these slides. Now you're going to notice here there is some overlapping. And that is because I should either tell ChatGPT to create titles that are only 2 words long or 3 words long so they don't go into overlap, or make this text smaller so that it can fit all of this. And I would do this in the main template. So right here, I would make this text, for example, 40, and the same would go with this text over here. And then just generate this again. And then it should probably fit inside of here. If it doesn't, I would go and fine tune it furthermore. It is a combination of fine tuning it here and also fine tuning it with the content that is generated. Now, if you have stayed with me for so long, I imagine that you like this kind of content. Thank you so much for watching my videos. And if you want to see the next steps of this video, of how we can post this to multiple channels also without doing anything once we set up our automation, please leave me a like and a comment below, and I will share that process as well. It has been a pleasure as always. Without you, this channel would not exist. So thank you for your support, and I will see you in the next automation.